Just on the IT raids at the Eagleton Resort. I'm Seher Zama. The latest that we're getting in on this with those ongoing raids there, almost on its last leg as far as Eagleton Golf Resort there is concerned, but still on in several other locations, especially two residences there of the state. Karnataka State Minister D.K. Shivakumar, that's what the IT has been maintaining, the IT department all along, that this is not, of course, to target the Congress MLAs from Gujarat who've been camping there in Bengaluru at this resort. The IT department carrying out raids at D.K. Shivakumar's residence as well, apart from 30 plus other locations. IT raids at 39 locations which are on across India, all related to the Karnataka State Minister here, D.K. Shivakumar.
Sir, your first reaction on the raids? Sir, your first reaction on the raids? What you have to tell about the raids?
For the first time, I have seen that the state itself has turned anarchist. And if the state turns anarchist, then it is very dangerous for democracy. ये बात नैतिकता की करते हैं. मैं आपको याद दिलाना चाहता हूं कि जब उत्तराखंड में इलेक्शन हो रहा था तो आपको मालूम है कि हमारे कांग्रेस पार्टी के एमएलए को इन्होंने स्पाइस जेट की स्पेशल फ्लाइट में 1:30 बजे रात को इन्होंने वहां से रवाना किया और ये फिर कई रिजॉर्ट्स में उनको लेकर गए ताकि चुनाव से पहले हम उनसे कोई बातचीत नहीं कर पाएं. तो मैं अरुण जेटली से पूछना चाहता हूं कि तब आपने क्या इनकम टैक्स के द्वारा कोई रेड करवाया था? मैं प्रधानमंत्री से पूछना चाहता हूं, तब क्या आपने कोई सेंट्रल फोर्सेस भेजी थी कि आज आपको जरूरत पड़ रही है वो सेंट्रल फोर्सेस भेजने की? तब तो आपको नैतिकता की याद नहीं आई. आप रोज संघीय ढांचे की बात करते हैं कि क्या ये फेडरलिज्म का चिन्ह है आपका? क्या ये कोऑपरेटिव फेडरलिज्म है कि आप राज्य सरकार को बिना पूछे हुए वहां सेंट्रल फोर्सेस भेज दो? आपको ये भी याद होगा कि अरुणाचल में किस तरह से आपने वहां गवर्नर बैठा रखे हैं, हालांकि आपके लगभग सारी राज्य सरकारों में आरएसएस के गवर्नर हैं, लेकिन ऐसे गवर्नर जो सरकार वहां ऑपोजिशन के साथ मिलकर उन्होंने सारी कांग्रेस सरकार को गिरा दिया और खरीद लिया आप लोगों ने. तो एक तरफ तो आप भाषण देते हो नैतिकता का, एक तरफ आप कहते हो फेडरलिज्म, कोऑपरेटिव फेडरलिज्म की बात करते हो और उसी फेडरलिज्म के पर आप प्रहार करते हो, उसी फेडरलिज्म को आप दबोचते हो, उसी फेडरलिज्म को आप खत्म करना चाहते हो. ये सरकार कोई लोकतंत्र सरकार नहीं है. ये सरकार एक ऐसी सरकार है जो चाहती है कि ऑपोजिशन बेंचेज में कोई ना बैठा रहे, कि सारे 245 लोग राज्यसभा में केवल भाजपा के हों और सारे 550 के लगभग लोग लोकसभा में 545 लोग भी भाजपा के हों. ये इनका लक्ष्य है और ये सारे 550 के लगभग लोग लोकसभा में 545 लोग भी भाजपा के हों. ये इनका लक्ष्य है और ये कोशिश करेंगे कि सारे ऑपोजिशन को खत्म करें और अपने लोग वहां पे बैठाएं. हम ऐसा नहीं होने देंगे. और अगर ये सोचते हैं कि ये करके ये हमारे साथ हम पार्लियामेंट में हम इनको इनके साथ कोऑपरेट करेंगे तो इनको गलत फहमी है. मुझे याद है अरुण जेटली जी ने जब ये ऑपोजिशन में थे इन्होंने बयान दिया था कि यू कैनॉट होप दैट वी विल कोऑपरेट विद यू इफ यू डू नॉट इफ यू टारगेट आर पीपल. एंड आई वॉन्ट टू टेल मिस्टर अरुण जेटली, डू नॉट होप ऑफ एनी कोऑपरेशन फॉर अस इफ यू टारगेट आर पीपल एंड आर गवर्नमेंट इन दिस फैशन. थैंक यू. और ये भी एक आश्चर्य की बात है कि सेक्रेटरी एक सर्कुलर भेजता है कि नोटा गुजरात के राज्यसभा के इलेक्शन में लागू होगा. आज हमने सुप्रीम कोर्ट में मेंशन किया था और वो मामला कल सुबह सुप्रीम कोर्ट में आएगा. और हमें इस बात का भी आश्चर्य है कि इलेक्शन कमीशन ने ऐसा निर्णय लिया है जो अपने आप में असंवैधानिक है, लेकिन वो बात तो हम कल सुप्रीम कोर्ट में करेंगे.
That, of course, being a reaction coming in from the senior Congress leader. Kapil Sibal saying that this is a clear sign of targeting. Also on a warning note saying if this is targeting, which is what the Congress believes is a case of a political witch hunt, there will be no cooperation from the Congress in the future if required by the government. We have with us our senior editor Jay Prakash getting us further details there from outside the Eagleton Resort there in Bengaluru, where raids, at least as far as the resort is concerned, almost in its last leg. Other residences, other 39 locations that are being raided across the country. Jay Prakash, please get us further inputs on raids that are on in other locations. Are we to understand each of these directly connected with the State Minister D.K. Shivakumar?
Well, absolutely. Apart from Eagleton Golf Resort, where we are reporting from, where the raids have concluded and the last batch of IT sleuths have left the premises of Eagleton, but along with them, they've got Vinay Kulkarni, one of the general secretaries of the Congress party and also very close man of D.K. Shivakumar, because there is a raid which is going on at his residence in Bangalore. So 3 to 4 leaders accompanying him, they've all left the premises. Apart from this Eagleton Golf Resort, simultaneous searches are happening in other places. One is the Kanakpura residence of D.K. Shivakumar, and then there is one in Sadashiv Nagar, that's his residence where he stays in Bangalore, and the third one being this minister's residence in Delhi. So in three places, apart from Eagleton Golf Resort, totally about 4 places where the raids took place. One has concluded and 3 others are underway. And right now, the Sadashiv Nagar residence, that is where all the action is, because the minister was taken by the IT sleuths from this resort at around 10:35, and they reached the Sadashiv Nagar residence around 12 o'clock. And questioning is going on there, and it seems that this is not going to end very soon, because there's a lot of incriminating documents and evidences that the IT department have got, and they're corroborating with those by confronting the minister himself, who's in person at the Sadashiv Nagar residence there.
Right, Jay, but apart from him, who else has been taken in? We were being told earlier that other Congress workers, local leaders have been taken in by the IT department as well.
Yeah, one prominent leader by name Vinay Kulkarni, he is the general secretary of the Congress party here in Karnataka, KPCC general secretary. He was also camping with both the brothers D.K. Suresh and D.K. Shivakumar here at the Eagleton Golf Resort for the last 4 to 5 days. He was taken away by the IT sleuths because the raid has been happening at his residence in Bangalore, and he will also be confronted with the documents what they've got there. But the talk about huge cache of currency being found in the residences of D.K. Shivakumar in Bangalore as well as Delhi has to be corroborated or confirmed by the IT department. But initial reports that are reaching us say that 5 crore cash at the Delhi residence and 3 crore hard cash from his Sadashiv Nagar residence. But there is no confirmation whatsoever from the IT department. But we'll have to wait and see how this is going to pan out, because it has actually turned into a very ugly situation for the Pradesh Congress, because we're seeing protests have started at 2 places, one outside D.K. Shivakumar's residence there and the other one at the Maurya Circle, because the Congress has taken
Absolutely.
It personally
there
now.
There are protests that the Congress is conducting here in Delhi as well. And talking about Parliament proceedings, it has impacted both Houses of Parliament. This is how it played out earlier in the day, both in the Lok Sabha as well as the Rajya Sabha. Let's take a listen in.
Our grave concerns over the attempt to derail and hijack elections to the Council of States.
That is already
misusing state authority and power.
You cannot raise it every day.
Because the MLAs were being abducted,
you cannot raise it every day.
Location. Now in Bangalore, where the MLAs are there, since morning they have started income tax raids and ET raids and against the Congress ministers.
No, Congress the point is you listen.
D.K. Shivakumar, yes. Is a very serious
finance minister.
जो आपकी पार्टी के लोग पैसे बांट रहे हैं उन पर रेड करो. ये जो 15-15 करोड़ लोग 15 करोड़ ऑफर कर रहे हैं उन पर रेड, उनके घर पे रेड करो, न कि उनके घर. सर, ये इलेक्शन फ्री एंड फेयर होने चाहिए एंड विदाउट फेयर होने चाहिए. ये इंश्योर करना पड़ेगा इस सदन को और इलेक्शन कमीशन को. ये इलेक्शन के दौरान जब इलेक्शन प्रोसेस शुरू हो रहा है, 3 दिन इलेक्शन को रहे और डराने के लिए, धमकाने के लिए आप गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया की, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट की तमाम एजेंसियां इस्तेमाल की. अब गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया की एजेंसियां इस्तेमाल कर रहे हैं. ये देश में क्या हो रहा? ये लोकतंत्र के खिलाफ? ये कैसा लोकतंत्र है?
इनकम टैक्स के अधिकारी, इसलिए उनका स्टेटमेंट लेना और उनको वहां से अपने घर ले जाना केवल इस पर्पस के लिए रिजोर्ट में गए। जब वहां पहुंचे तो व्यक्ति वहां पर कागज फाड़ रहे थे, वो फटे हुए कागज भी और जो डॉक्यूमेंट्स फाड़ रहे थे वो भी पंचनामा में रिकवर हुए, उनको वहां से लेकर उनके घर पे चले गए। आज इस वक्त वहां पर कोई इनकम टैक्स का अधिकारी नहीं है। ये रेड 39 अन्य स्थानों पर चल रही है, इसको गुजरात के किसी चुनाव के साथ मत जोड़िए, इसको केवल आर्थिक अपराध के साथ जोड़िए।
जिस रूम में वो थे उस रूम को भी उन्होंने सर्च किया। अब इसीलिए मैं ये चाहता हूं कि अगर इस ढंग से वेंडेटा विच हंटिंग अगर इस देश में चला तो कोई पार्टी डेमोक्रेसी में बच नहीं सकती। ठीक है, किसी कोई अगर इकोनॉमिकल ऑफेंस किया है, कोई व्यक्ति, कोई लीडर, कोई भी होने दो, अगर मैं भी अगर किया हूं तो आप कानूनन मेरे ऊपर एक्शन लीजिए। लेकिन आप पॉलिटिकली एक इलेक्शन जीतने के लिए, एक राज्यसभा का उम्मीदवार को हराने के लिए आप ये जो कोशिश कर रहे हैं इसमें कामयाब नहीं बनेंगे।
Further inputs there coming in from both Bengaluru with our colleague Jay Prakash as well as our senior executive editor Priya Sehgal on this as well, on how it is impacting politics for the Congress. Very quickly, first to you, Jay, on the update that you have on these ongoing raids here, on the leaders who've been picked up by the IT department and the findings that have come in so far.
Well, absolutely. No sooner the news about IT raids at Eagleton Golf Resort was broke by NewsX, in fact, sent ripples through the Congress's rank and file, because multiple raids, what we saw, one was at Eagleton Golf Resort, the epicenter of all the major controversies around resort politics being played out from Bangalore. The second one, the Sadashivnagar residence of DK Shivakumar. The third one is the residence at Kanakpura, where this is the hometown of DK Shivakumar, and the fourth one at his Delhi resort. Mm-hmm. Now, there was a lot of criticism from the opposition, rather the Congress, that this was politically motivated and they wanted to intimidate the Congress legislators from Gujarat who are holed up at this resort for the last 4 to 5 days. The IT department on its behalf clarified with a press release saying that this is part of the ongoing investigations by the IT wing, IT investigation wing of Bangalore and Goa Circle, and there have been investigations going on against DK Shivakumar for a considerable amount of time, and that in continuation with those searches and investigations that are being carried out, these raids and searches happen, and there is no need to give it any political color or twist. But the fact of the matter remains that the IT sleuths swooped down on the very resort. The biggest team of about 14 sleuths in 3 cars landed at this resort at 7:15 in the morning, sending shockwaves across the Congress camp residing at this very resort for the last 4 days.
Okay, so irrespective of the explanation, the clarification that's coming from the IT department, the explanation painstakingly put across by the central government, the BJP and both houses of parliament here, it is the timing which is suspect, Priya, that the Congress has been maintaining all along.
Exactly. The Congress, of course, is linking this with the Gujarat Rajya Sabha elections that are due on the 8th. Now, the Gujarat MLAs, as you know, were camping in this resort. There was allegations of horse trading, of money changing hands, and a whole lot of money has been found over there also, which makes you wonder exactly where the source of that funds is also. But at the end of the day, it is linked to a very high profile battle which the Congress has alleged as a witch hunt. Ahmed Patel has been tweeting since the morning, saying murder of democracy. He's also said that it is personal between him and Amit Shah. The fact is that Ahmed Patel loses the election. If you just move away from the raids, why is so much being made about this particular election and these high profile raids? Is the nature of the men involved. Ahmed Patel is Sonia Gandhi's chief strategist. He's the chief advisor, and his position is that of strength. So if you target him, that's a symbolic blow to the Congress as a whole, to Sonia Gandhi's leadership and to the entire morale of the Congress. That is why it is so important for the BJP to win this seat and for the Congress also to try and retain it.
All right, Priya, I appreciate you putting this in perspective here on what the Congress says. This is certainly politically playing out in the form of these raids there. Jay, many thanks for getting us those inputs as well. We're switching focus to our